What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Nurse Bass back with another video, and welcome to the next installment of our brand new video series, Mastering ABGs, paid for and sponsored by YouTube to truly help you guys be able to master ABGs and to begin crushing those exams, but more importantly, to be able to help you better take care of your patients.
Are you listening?
Nurse Bass. Beast mode.
So this particular installment here is going to be a bit of a recap, but to provide you a little bit more information. So what we're talking about, we've talked about CO2 regulation. We've talked about bicarbonate regulation. Now I want to dive a little bit deeper into how those directly help affect our pH. So the recap part, CO2, excreted by the lungs. That's how we get rid of the waste product. Normal homeostatic range of CO2 is 35 to 45. Bicarbonate, regulated by the kidneys. Normal homeostatic range of 22 to 26. And again, both of these play a direct result in influencing our blood pH. Homeostatic range, 7.35 to 7.45. So, let's dive a little bit deeper. I want to first focus on CO2. 35 to 45 is our range. We have mentioned previously how CO2, the waste product, is acidotic by nature. It's acidotic. So, if you have a CO2 level of 50, what does that mean? That means that you are more acidotic than that homeostatic range of 35 to 45. You have more acid in the blood than you would normally need. So, if you have more acid in your blood than you would normally need, how would that affect your blood pH? Remember, the whole range is 0 to 14, and our blood pH is 7.35 to 7.45. If your CO2 is 50, if you have more acid than you need, it's going to make your blood pH more acidotic. Makes sense, right? So what does that look like in that 7.35 to 7.45 range? 7.35 to 7.45. It's going to make you more acidotic, pushing you below 7.35, right? Because 0 is acid, 14 is basic or alkalinic. It's going to push you more towards 0. It's going to push you more in the acidotic direction. Okay. How about for that hyperventilating patient that we talked about, who's blowing off all of their CO2 in a panic-induced state? Because they're blowing off all of their CO2, they're no longer in the 35 to 45 range. They may now be in the 30. They may be 25. And because CO2 is an acid, we now have less acid than what is normal. It's a tough one to think about. You think acid is a bad thing. Remember, we already have a normal range of 35 to 45. That means we do have some acid in us that makes us up, that produces the blood pH of 7.35 to 7.45. So it's normal for us to have some. Too much is a bad thing. Too little is also a bad thing. So the hyperventilating patient has a CO2 level of 25, let's say. How does that affect our blood pH? Too little acid now pushes you towards an alkalinic state. So you're blowing off too much CO2, you're blowing off too much acid, pushing your blood pH towards an alkalinic state. So now you're going to be above 7.45. Makes sense, right? I hope you're staying with me. And this is all going to make sense in the upcoming videos whenever we break this down on our diagram. That's CO2. Now let's talk about bicarbonate. Bicarbonate, as we've previously stated, is a base. It's basic. It is alkalinic. That's what bicarbonate is. Normal range is 22 to 26. 22 to 26. We're sitting happy, we're sitting pretty. We have some base in us, but we have just that right amount that yields a homeostatic blood pH. So now you have a patient and your ABG result reads that their bicarbonate is 35. That's well above 26, right? So that means that you have too much base. You're too alkalinic. And if you have too much base, where does that push your blood pH? Towards a more alkalinic state. So now you would be above 7.45. On the other hand, let's say you had too little bicarbonate. Let's say your bicarbonate level was 15. Remember, the normal was 22 to 26. So if you have a bicarbonate level of 15, you have too little base. That could mean more free hydrogen ions than normal. So because you have too little base, that's going to put you in a more acidotic state. So instead of being 7.35 to 7.45, you may now be in that 7.25 range. You'd be more acidotic. It's always important to remember, whenever you're talking about these complex subjects, acid-base balance really is what we're talking about. That's what ABGs are. It's a balance of your acids and your bases. Too much CO2, too much acid, you're acidotic. You're below a blood pH of 7.35. Too little acid, too little CO2, you get pushed towards an alkalinic state, a basic state above 7.45. Too much bicarbonate, too much base, you're too alkalinic or alkalotic. You're above 7.45 at that point. Too little base. Not enough buffer for those free hydrogen ions. Too little bicarbonate. You get pushed towards an acidotic state. And so it's that fine balance of the acids and bases that produces a homeostatic blood pH. It is the balance of these two things that yields that blood pH of 7.35 to 7.45. I hope that made sense. It's the best way I know how to teach it to you guys. If you can grasp that, and you can grasp that understanding, then you're gonna do well. And like I said, whenever we get into this next video, and we start breaking down the method, the primary method by which we're going to solve these ABG problems, then you're gonna have a better understanding of exactly how these acid and bases work together to balance out to produce that nice homeostatic blood pH. It's gonna help you out a lot, guys. I hope that you enjoyed the video. Make sure that you stay tuned for the next one. It's your boy, Nurse Bass, and I'll see you there. Peace.